My dear students, in this class we are going to discuss these three Boolean laws. First one is complementary law, second one is commutative law, third one is associative law. In the last class we started to discuss Boolean theorems. There we already studied properties of 0 and 1. And next we studied indeterminacy law, and afterwards we studied involution law. Today we are going to discuss these three law. Now see, let us, first one is complementary law. Complementary law. This law states that when a variable is combined with its complement form, then it gives 1. That is, that is, this complementary law states that when we are going to combine a variable with its complement form, when it undergoes logical addition or logical multiplication, it gives result like this: x plus x bar is equal to 1, x into x bar is equal to 0. So this is mean by complementary law. What is complementary law? When a variable is combined with its complement form and when it undergoes logical addition, it gives 1. That is, x plus x bar is equal to 1. And another, this is called complementary addition law. And second one is complementary multiplication law. It states that when a variable x is going to combine with its complement form and undergoes logical multiplication, it gives 0. That is, x into x bar is equal to 0. This is what complementary law. Now we have to prove this complementary law either using proof by perfect induction method or truth table. Now let us prove this complementary law using proof by perfect induction method. Now take first one, proof for x plus x bar is equal to 1. Proof for x plus x bar is equal to 1 using proof by perfect induction method means first one, x plus x bar is equal to 1. Proof by perfect induction method means we have to put x value 0 and next time we have to put x value 1. So put x equal to 0. LX is equal to x plus x bar, which will be equal to 0 plus 0 bar, which will be equal to 0 plus 1, which will be equal to 1. So this will be equal to R. Put x equal to 1, then LX is equal to x plus x bar is equal to 1 plus 1 bar is equal to 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. This 1 is nothing but RHS, right? Is equal to RHS. So whenever going to put the x value 0, we get LHS is equal to RHS equal to 1. When we are going to put x equal to 1, LHS equal to RHS equal to 1. Therefore, for every value of x plus x bar is equal to 1 is true. So this is what proof for x plus x bar is equal to 1. Now say second one, b x into x bar is equal to 0. This is for complementary law for multiplication. X into x bar is equal to 0. Now we have to prove this using proof by perfect induction method. Means put x equal to 0, then LHS is equal to x into x bar is equal to 0 into 0 bar is equal to 0 into 1 is equal to 0. RHS is 0, therefore which will be equal to RHS. Right? Put x equal to 1, x equal to 1, then LHS is equal to x into x bar is equal to 1 into 1 bar is equal to 1 into 0 is equal to 0, which will be equal to RHS. See here, what is happening? Whenever we are going to put x equal to 0, we are going to get LHS equal to RHS equal to 0. When we are going to put x is equal to 1, we are going to get LHS equal to RHS equal to 0. Therefore, for each values of x, x into x bar is equal to 0. Right? For each value of x, x into x bar is equal to 0. This is what? Complementary law. What is mean by complementary law? When a variable is going to combine with its complement for, when it undergoes logical addition, it gives 1. Similarly, when a variable x combined with its complement for and undergoes logical multiplication, it gives 0. So this is what complementary law. So now we proved this complementary law using proof by perfect induction method. In the exam, suppose he is asked, state the complementary law or prove the complementary law. Means first we have to say the definition of complementary law. Means these two things, x plus x bar equal to 1 and x into x bar is equal to 0. And afterwards prove these two, either truth table or prove by perfect induction method. So now prove by perfect induction method. The same thing we can also prove using truth table. The same thing can also be proved using truth table. Now see how it is possible. Afterwards, we have to find the number of input combinations. Afterwards, we have to draw truth table, right? So see here, only one variable is there, therefore number of variable is equal to 1. How to find the input combination using formula 2 power n, where n is the number of variable, here n value 1, 2 power 1 is equal to 2 input cases. Now we have to draw 2 input cases for the for this one variable. Only one variable is there, so take one variable x. For this one variable, two combinations are there, two cases, that is 0 and 1. Right? Now, what we have to find? X plus x bar equal to 1, we have to do, right? So, see here, x is there. To perform x plus x bar, we have to find x bar here. X bar. X bar means complement of x column 1, 0. Now, find the x plus x bar. X plus x bar. X plus x bar means here x is there, x bar column is there, perform logical addition, that is 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 0, 1. So, what is this? From this truth table, what we can say? We have to prove x plus x bar equal to 1. See, observe in this truth table, observe the column 3. X plus x bar 1, 1 is there. Means, for all the input combinations, we get 1. For all the input combinations, if input x is, x 0 is there, we get 1. If input x 1 is there, we get 1. So, x plus x bar equal to 1 we have to get. So, in this truth table, from column 3, we can say that x plus x bar equal to 1. X plus x bar equal to 1. And one important thing here, we have to note here, that is, in the resultant column, all the possible output is 1. For this case, output is 1. For this case, output is 1. That is, in the truth table, in the resultant column, for each, in the resultant column, for each input case, output is 1, 1 means it is called tautology. That is, what is the tautology? It is a step in a truth table where resultant column value must be 1. So, now we prove x plus x bar is equal to 1. Let us see second one. X into x bar is equal to 0. X into x bar is equal to 0. Put x into x bar equal to 0. So, this can be proved using In the last one means right now we proved x plus x bar equal to 1 using proof by induction method as well as a truth table. Now any one is needed. Now I am going to prove it x into x bar equal to 0 using truth table. See here, how many variables are there? Number of variable is equal to 1. 2 power n, where n is the variable, 2 power 1 is equal to 2 input cases, 2 input cases, that is x possible combinations are 0, 1. Now x into x bar is there. To perform x into x bar, we must need x bar. Okay. So it becomes 1, 0. X into x bar. X into x bar. Perform between x and x bar logical manipulation, we get 0, 0. See here, x into x bar equal to 0. Observe the last column, x into x bar column 0, 0. That is, for all input cases, we get 0, 0. Therefore, from the truth table, we can say that x into x bar is equal to 0 for all input cases. And just observe here, in the last column, all the truth values are 0, 0. All the truth values are 0, 0 for all the input cases. If input case is 0, we get 0. If input case is 1, we get 0. Like that, in the truth table, resultant column, all truth values are 0, then it is called falsity. Falsity. In the last one, that is x plus x bar equal to 1, there all the truth values are 1, true for all the input combinations. If all the truth values are 1, are true, then it is called tautology. Like that here, all the truth values are 0, 0 in the truth table. So such a situation is called fallacy. So now let us see next law, that is commutative law. Complementary law is over. Now let us see next law, that is commutative law. Fifth one, commutative law. Commutative law states that first thing, x plus y is equal to y plus x. This, what is mean by commutative law? Means commutative law states that x plus y is equal to y plus x. Second one, x into y is equal to y into x, where x comma y are the boolean variables. Boolean variables. What is mean by commutative law? Commutative law states that x plus y equal to y plus x. Second one, x into y is equal to y into x, where x comma y are the boolean variables. X comma y are the boolean variables. Now let us prove it using, we can prove these things using prove by perfect induction method or truth table. Now let us prove it using proof for first one, x plus y is equal to y plus x, using perfect induction method. Perfect induction method. What it says, first we have to consider given boolean, given law, that is x plus y is equal to y plus x. Substitute part first, put x equal to 0. Then what happens in LHS? LHS equal to x plus y, which will be equal to 0 plus y, which will be equal to y. Consider RHS, which will be equal to y plus x, which will be equal to y plus 0, which will be equal to y. Right? When we are going to substitute, put x equal to 0, we get LHS equal to RHS equal to Y. Right? Now see, put X equal to 1, X equal to 1, then LHS equal to X plus Y, which will be equal to 1 plus Y, which will be equal to 1, because properties of 0 and 1, 1 plus X is equal to 1, 1 plus any means 1 plus any boolean variable is equal to 1, so 1 plus Y means 1, because 1 plus X is equal to 1, log, right, we have to mention there why it is 1. Next, RHS, which will be equal to Y plus X, which will be equal to Y plus 1, which will be equal to 1 plus Y or Y plus 1, both are equal, that is 1 plus any boolean variable equal to 1, because log, what is the log, 1 plus X is equal to 1. So observe here, for X equal to 1, LHS equal to RHS equal to 1, right? So therefore, we can prove, we proved it, X plus Y equal to Y plus X. Now, just consider this second one, X into Y equal to Y into X. Now prove it, second one. Y equal to Y into X, right? X into Y equal to Y into X. Put X equal to 0, then LHS is equal to X into Y is equal to 0 into Y is equal to 0, right? Consider RHS, X, Y into X, which will be equal to Y into 0, which will be equal to 0. LHS is also 0, RHS is also 0. When X equal to 0. Now put X is equal to 1. X is equal to 1. Then LHS is equal to X into Y. LHS is equal to X into Y, which will be equal to 1 into Y. Will be equal to Y, because properties of 1, 1 plus any boolean variable equal to 1, 1 into boolean variable equal to that boolean variable. RHS is equal to Y into X is equal to Y into 1 is equal to Y. So here also LHS and RHS are equal, therefore we can say that X into second one, X into Y is equal to Y into X is true. So in this way we have to prove, in this way we have to prove X plus Y is equal to Y plus Z and X into Y equal to Y into Z. Now consider third one, associative law. This associative law states that X plus bracket of Y plus Z is equal to bracket of X plus Y plus Z. And second one, this is A. Second one, X into bracket of Y into Z is equal to bracket of X into Y into Z. See here. Sixth one, associative law. Associative law. This associative law states that first one, x plus bracket of y plus z is equal to bracket of x plus y plus z. Second one, x into bracket of y into z is equal to bracket of x into y into z. Right? So, what is associative law? This associative law states that x plus bracket of y plus z is equal to bracket of x plus y plus x plus z. And second one, x into bracket of y plus y into z is equal to bracket of x into y into z. Now, just consider the first statement and prove it. First one, x plus bracket of y plus z is equal to x plus y plus z. Right? Now we can prove it in two way. First one is using proved by perfect induction method. Second one is using truth table. Now for this law I am going to try to prove it using truth table. Okay, you can try in home using proved by perfect induction method. So here in this expression, how many variables are there? X, y, z, three variables are there. Therefore number of variables is equal to 3. Next, to find the input combination purpose, we have to use formula 2 power n, where n is the number of variable. 2 power 3 is equal to 8 input cases. 8 input cases. So draw a truth table with the 8 input cases. Consider 3 variables x, y and z. First write the 8 input cases for the variable x, that is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. I already told in the last class how to fill 8 input combinations. It is easy to remember. First write 4 zeros and afterwards write 4 ones. For the remaining yz, how to write combinations means we have to use for this yz, we have to write for two variable input combination standard cases, that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 0, 1, 1. Now for the remaining 4 cases, write once again same thing, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Right? Now see the expression. In the LHS side, what is there? X plus bracket of y plus z is there. Complement is not there in the LHS side as well as RHS side. So first we have to consider this inner block, that is y plus z. How to find this y plus z? This is possible by considering y and z column. Logical addition between these two, that is 0 plus 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. Right? Now, x plus bracket of y plus z is there. Now, y plus z is over. Consider this first column 1 and this column 4. Perform x plus bracket of y plus z. So consider this x first column and fourth column. Perform between these two logical addition, that is 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. 10 remaining 7 marks. Now LHS part is over. For the RHS also we get the value 0 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 means it is 2. So see in the RHS side, first what is there here? Bracket of x plus y plus z is there. Find plus first bracket of x plus y. So how x plus y is open by considering first column and second column. 0 0 1 1 1 1 1. Now consider this column and z column. Perform bracket of x plus y plus z. Consider this column and z column. We get 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Right? Now, observe this truth table. Column 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Column 5 and column 7. Column 5 means LHS, x plus bracket of y plus z. Column 7 means RHS, x plus y bracket of plus z. Both columns are identical, that is 0 0, 1 1, 1 1, 1 1, 1 1, 1 1, 1 1, 1. Right? From this truth table, in this truth table, consider column 5 and column 6. Consider column 5 and 6. Both are identical for each case. Both are identical for each case. Therefore, we can say that x plus bracket of y plus z is equal to bracket of x plus y plus z. Right? So this is what proving associative law of first one, x plus bracket of y plus z is equal to bracket of x plus y plus z. This is over. This is called associative law of addition. This is also called associative law of addition because only addition is there. Observe the second one. Associative law of second one says that x into bracket of y into z bracket close is equal to bracket of x into y bracket close into z. Only logical multiplication is there. That's why it is called associative law of multiplication. Associative law of multiplication. Right? So now we are going to prove associative law of multiplication. This associative law of multiplication, x into bracket of y into z is equal to bracket of x into y into z. Associative law of multiplication can also be proved in two ways. One is proved by perfect induction method. Second one is truth table. Associative law of addition is proved using truth table. Now I am going to prove it using proved by perfect induction method. You try it in home using truth table. Okay. So, what is the associative law of multiplication? Second one, it says that x into bracket of y into z is equal to bracket of x into 1 into z. Right? Here, prove y. Perfect induction method. Prove by perfect induction method. And means I am going to prove it by perfect induction method. So how it is possible? By substituting first x value 0 and afterwards substituting x value 1. So put x is equal to 0. What happens in the LHS? I take LHS. LHS is equal to x into bracket of y into z, which will be equal to 0 into bracket of y into z. 0 into anything is 0. Consider RHS, which will be equal to bracket of x into y into z. Equal to bracket of 0 into y into z is equal to 0 into anything. So LHS is 0, RHS is also 0. Right? Now put x is equal to 1. X is equal to 1. Then what happens in LHS? LHS is equal to x into bracket of y into z is equal to 1 into y into z is equal to 1 is equal to y into z only. 1 into y into z. Now RHS, which will be equal to bracket of x into y into z is equal to 1 into y into z is equal to 1 into y means y, y into z. So here when x is equal to 0, we get LHS 0, RHS is also 0. When x is equal to 1, LHS is y into z, RHS is y into z. We get both LHS and RHS values are same for each value of variable x. Therefore, we can say that x into bracket of y into z is equal to x into y into z. So this is what associative law of addition as well as multiplication. So in this class, we discussed these three laws, that is complementary law and in this class we discussed three laws, that is complementary law is over, commutative law is over, associative law is over. In the next class we will see remaining Boolean theorems. Thank you.